Hey, I'm David. I am half a folk on the move. My partner Alexa is working on a different project at the moment. So I'm doing this video and I decided to show you how we built our lower cabinet, the kitchen cabinet here, and how we built the upper cabinet in our bedroom. This is like our clothing closet. And this whole beast here is essentially everything that we use for our kitchen. We have the fridge, stove, sink, gray water tank, along with some additional storage. So excited to show you how we did it. We get a lot of questions about that, so hopefully this answers those questions, or is just entertaining if you're curious how someone goes about a project like this. Let's get into it. Let's talk about our kitchen cabinet first. This cabinet holds our fridge, sink, stove, gray water tank, and a sliding drawer full of spices and other food items. Our design was pretty simple. We constructed two boxes of approximately the same size. One would hold the fridge and the stove, the other would hold the sink and gray water tank. The tall drawer in the middle attaches the two boxes, making it one single unit once the siding was put on. We built the fridge box first. The first step in this process was to build a platform for the box to sit on so that it was raised a few inches off the ground to allow a toe kick. We built the box using Craig pocket hole jigs, I'll have that link below, and we built it out of 1x3 boards. Quick note about the pocket jig, this is a super handy tool and we used it for so many projects on the build. Definitely worth the investment, and really it's not even that expensive. The only trick is getting the right screws and learning how to use it. The next step was to cut a plywood top for the platform. This was for the fridge to sit on, and we cut it so that it extended over the platform, creating the toe kick. Make sure whatever plywood you choose to use for this part is strong enough to support the fridge or whatever you decide to put on the platform. Next, we framed in the fridge using 1x3s and the pocket jig. As you can see, there is a large gap behind the fridge and the end of the platform that it sits on. We did this on purpose to allow plenty of airflow behind the fridge so that it doesn't overheat. Be sure to consider ventilation when placing your fridge. On to box number two. We built this one to be approximately the same size and with the toe kick matching the first box, so that when these two boxes were put in line, they would be more or less the same. Our original idea with this design was to have our propane locker on the second box and to have our Propex heater underneath the sliding drawer in between the two boxes. We ended up changing this plan later on, so this footage is a little deceiving, but the gist of it is the same. So where that propane locker is sitting is actually where our gray water tank sits, and the Propex heater is not in the spot shown before. We constructed the frame of box number two using the same pocket jig technique with 1x3s. We weren't sure how much support the sink would need, so we went a little overboard with the supports. With the two boxes finished, we moved on to building our sliding drawer. We built it out of half-inch plywood and the pocket jig. We wanted to maximize space, so we made sure the drawer was wide enough to hold two cans side by side, and we spaced the compartments out so we could place tall items in the drawer as well as short items without losing any space. Building the drawer was a delicate process. It took lots of precise measurements, something that I'm notoriously bad at, but we got there in the end. It's also worth mentioning that plywood is probably not the best kind of wood to build a drawer like this out of, but we had extra plywood and decided to make it work. On to easily the most frustrating part of the whole cabinet, the soft closing drawer slides. Because nothing in the van is level, and because most of my measurements and the cuts I made in the cabinets were pretty rough, it took a lot of trial and error to get these drawer slides to work, because they need to align just right to work properly. What I found worked best was measuring from the floor of the van and up to the point that I wanted to install the slide, then replicating that measurement at each screw point. Like I said, it took a lot of trial and error, but this method worked in the end. And it seems silly now, seeing as we were able to build so many unique things in the van, but this was the first real challenge that we faced dealing with hardware and moving pieces. So it was so satisfying seeing it open and close smoothly and successfully. We're gonna skip right over siding and onto the countertop for this cabinet. We thought about investing in butcher block, but decided to save some money and make our own DIY countertops out of 1x8 pine boards. My grandpa helped us to construct the wood countertops out of biscuit joints and wood glue. We love the final result. The wood grain is really cool and unique. We also like how lightweight this countertop is, and how sturdy it is. So far, it's worked great. Next, we cut holes in our countertop for our stove and sink using a jigsaw. I was nervous to make the cuts because the room for error was slim, but we made it through without incident. Be sure to tape around your cut lines using a painter's tape or some other light tape so that you don't scratch the wood surface with the jigsaw as you're making the cut. Lots of sanding and several liberal coats of safe coat sealant later, and our countertop was ready to go. And here is the final result. We love how this entire cabinet turned out. It's very sturdy, functional, has lots of storage. There's even space that we could probably reorganize or use better to hold more things in the future if we needed to. I didn't address the siding or how I built the door on the front and the back of this cabinet. The front door is how we get into the gray water in our garbage, and the door on the back is how we can easily access our gray water when we're dumping it. Time to dive into our bedroom closet and how we constructed it. We've seen a lot of videos and blogs detailing how to build up our van cabinets, and the way we did it is probably a hybrid of a few of these methods. The first step is to measure and cut a template for the end pieces of your cabinet, so that they match the angle of the van. For this cabinet, we knew we wanted to have two large compartments, so we each had our own space for our clothes. To do this, I cut three pieces, two for the ends and one for a middle divider. I then marked where I wanted to add the 1x2 connectors across the three pieces. Make sure these connectors line up with furring strips in your wall so you have something solid to mount the closet to when you're done. I used the jigsaw to cut out the spots for the 1x2s, then drilled screw holes in each slot using the pocket jig. Finally, we placed each 1x2 in its appropriate slot, then screwed the whole thing together. This frame was super lightweight and very sturdy. We mounted the frame to the wall using regular wood screws, then added a plywood bottom and doors of the same Baltic birch material. We repeated this entire process twice for the cabinet that's above our bench and for the cabinet that's above our kitchen, just making slight adjustments whether we wanted the cabinet to be deeper or taller. And here's the final result. Thanks for watching this week's video, this little tease into how we built these two cabinets. There's a lot more to say about all of this. For instance, how we ran the water through the cabinet and gas. Also, like how we finished the doors on the closet, what stain we used, the hardware we installed. So if you have any of those questions, feel free to reach out in the comments or directly. We'll probably do videos that address those questions in more detail down the road. So subscribing will keep you up to date on our new videos, and it also helps us out. So thanks in advance if you do subscribe. Otherwise, give us a like, comment, say hi. We love hearing from you. Be well. We'll see you next week.